Assalamualaikum everyone. Today our topic is acid basis and salt. Very important topic and very interesting subject. Okay, what is acid? Anyone? Okay, here. What does this lemon contain? Yes. If you have any stomachache or sometime gastric problem, they give you a lemon juice. Why? Because it nutrishes your stomach. Okay, means neutralizes your stomach. The acidity will goes on. Now in this lemon we have citric acid. Okay, in the lemon we have citric acid. There are so many neutral acids. Substances like we have our own behavior. Okay, like human beings have its own behavior, like they are tall, they are short. Now the substances have its own thing, how to define that. Means the substance we cannot say it is tall and short. The substances we say it is basic in nature or acidic in nature or neutral in nature. Okay, so now we have few things, how to differ that which subject is basic and which subject is acidic. Now for that we have few differences in that. First difference is the acids are salt in taste. Acids are salt in taste. What about the bases then? The bases are bitter in taste. Bases are bitter in taste. B for base, B for bitter. You can note that this B here, it's B. Okay, that is the first difference. And then next, so for everything, all the substances we cannot taste. So why we cannot taste? Because it is dangerous. The acidic thing, if we taste anything, it is dangerous for our health or our tongue. Okay, so with the taste we cannot specify anything. So the next step is, how can we do that? There is a neutralizing agent. That is, the neutralizing agent is nothing but the thing which we say, which give us, which subject, which substance is acidic or basic. For that, we will use the natural thing, that is the litmus paper. Litmus paper comes from the plant. Okay, natural, that is nothing but the natural obtained from the thallophyte, purple dye lichen plant, thallophyte it is. That litmus paper, what happens, once we dip in the acidic substance, it turns into red. Litmus paper turns into red. In blue litmus, this one blue litmus paper turns in red. The other side, what happens to that? So here the red litmus paper turns into blue, but red litmus turns blue. If that same blue paper comes here, and if it is acidic in nature, blue litmus paper turns into red. If it is not acidic, then what happens to that litmus paper? If there will be no change in that litmus paper. Okay, it remains as it is. The blue only remains as it is. Okay, now coming to this side, the red litmus paper, when we are dipping in the bases, it turns into blue. Okay, if not, if it is not a base, then there will be no change in the litmus paper. Clear? Then this is the one step. Then the next step.